Well, hello. God bless you, Bishop Patrick L. Wooden Sr. here. And happy Jesus Pride Month. I hope that you are enjoying the month of June as much as I am enjoying this month. I tell you, as we are celebrating the fact that we are proud of our association with the Galilean Wonder Worker. We're proud of our association with the Son of David, Seed of Abraham, the stone hewed out the mountain. Oh, he's a meek and humble lamb. And yes, oh yes, oh yes, I know him. He's my Savior. He's my Lord. And I'm enjoying these colors. As a matter of fact, I was just showing a story where the LGBTQ community is upset. They're upset with Target. They're upset with other retailers because they're saying that people are making money off of the rainbow. And they're not down for the movement. They're not down for the movement. I wonder what does the LGBTQ plus community expect Target to do? Become one of them? Well, listen, I'm not down with the movement either, and I'm not down with them having rights to God's rainbow. These colors doesn't symbolize a lifestyle that the Bible calls an abomination. These colors symbolize a promise that the God of the Bible made to mankind, made to every living creature, that he would not destroy the earth again with water. And every time he sees the bowl reminds him of the promise he made, and the bowl reminds us of the promise he made. As a matter of fact, just a few days ago, I was riding with some of the guys. We have a group at the church called the Upper Room Riders, and we were riding on, just doing a little quick 40-mile hike, and while we were on our sprint riding the bicycles, we were going up a hill, and in yonder's distance, that was the most beautiful rainbow that I'd seen in a long time. And it certainly didn't remind me of anything abominable. But it reminded me of the grace, the love, and the mercy of the God of the Bible. Oh, Jesus Christ, who died for you. He died for me. He died for everyone to set us free. The Bible said, to whom the Son set free, they're free indeed. The Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Free. Free to be who and what God made you to be. And God made every human being male and female, and he made every human being to be straight. So I thank God. I thank God. I want you to know that he's still in the delivering business. He will set you free. He loves you. But you got to come out of sin and let Jesus save you. Now, I'm enjoying this month. I'm having a ball with it. And not only am I enjoying it, but, you know, one of the things I'm so excited about is that when you serve the God of the Bible, you know, the truth does make you free. And Gary's putting on the screen here a picture. I don't know why. It's a story. I don't know why this is a story. It says, trans man who has given birth to two kids talks trauma of pregnancies. Now, everybody knows, and their uncle, you got to be living on Mars. Well, maybe Jupiter, maybe Saturn. You just got to be dumb. You got to not pay attention to anything to know that a trans man is a woman. Now, maybe they should have said a bearded woman who had her breasts removed and had her hair cut short, and she's been taking testosterone and other things to grow her a beard, that this woman who has mutilated her body, but she was smart enough to keep the ovaries, the fallopian tubes, and the rest of her female anatomy that God gave her, that she was born with, that she didn't have to go under the knife to have changed. Well, she was able to keep all of that, and that is why a woman gave birth twice. Is there anything newsworthy at all about the fact that a woman can give birth to more than can give birth twice? I don't know why this is a story. I guess it's a story because we are all supposed to pay attention and participate now in the lie. And we go, oh, a man had a baby. No, a man didn't have a baby. Men can't have babies. A woman gave birth. A woman who has had her perfectly healthy breasts removed. My heart goes out to women who have to contend with breast cancer and other things, and they have to have breast surgery to correct what has taken place as a result of what took place during the surgery. And it's a traumatic experience for women. And yet there are other women who, because of evil spirits speaking to their heads, telling them, you're a man, you're a man, you're a man, they will go and allow their healthy breasts to be removed. And you can look at the picture there. They didn't do a good job. Doesn't look like a guy's chest to me. And you see the hands there. You can tell that that's a woman, although they're trying hard and they got a nice beard up there. But sister, mommy, I pray that God will watch over you. And I tell you, I really pray for your children, because they're going to be raised in a web of lies. And then you know what's going to happen? The rest of the community is going to have to go along with the lie. When the kids go to school, the school and all the other children are going to be asked to go along with the lie. And sooner or later, you're talking about something traumatic, sooner or later, the children are going to find out the truth. You know, facts and truth, it's hard to hide it. It's hard to hide it. These things surface, and it's going to surface, and they're going to say, oh, Lord, we thought that daddy was a guy, and we found out that daddy is a girl. It's a girl, a messed up girl, a bearded woman, and who had her breast removed, but it's all a lie. And this is why Brother Wooden and others like me are telling you these things. We're going to keep it before you. People say, what's the big deal? People say, why do you talk about it so much? I don't know. Maybe July is adulterous month. And maybe August is robbers month to celebrate. Maybe September is another immoral lifestyle month. You see, my point is, they get a month. You got the Biden administration who is asking the courthouse, which is supposed to represent everybody, funded by everybody's money, taxpayer money. They're asking the courthouse to fly the LGBTQ flags on the grounds of the courthouse. Now, what if you're going to court and you got a case against a member of that community? You think you're going to get fairness with the sign blowing out there on the grounds of the courthouse? Oh, we need to pray. We need to pray. We got some crazy people in power, and they're pushing wickedness. Now, let me tell you, I got to wrap this up. I'm going long. I start talking about this stuff, and I get fired up because, now listen, I'm having a ball. I want you to know it. I'm enjoying this month, and look at this fly. Isn't this nice? And, you know, I keep one behind me there. And unless you're a brand new viewer of this ministry, you know what this is all about. Jesus pride. And yes, we're doing it because we picked this time, because they picked this time. We picked this month because they picked this month. We're not going to give this time to wickedness. We're not going to surrender the rainbow. God made the rainbow. Also, as I wrap this up, I love you. Thank you for watching today. I'm excited about our men's conference. It's on the screen there. We are his male servants. We are servants of the Most High God. The Bible says, in the last days, I will pour out of my spirit, saith God, upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. And even even on my handmaidens and servants, even down to the servants, not just the sons and the daughters, the old men and the young men, but down to my servants. God said, will I pour out of my spirit and they too shall prophesy. Well, I tell you, when he got down to the servants, when he got down to the slaves, he got down to me. Yes, yes, that this is where we were, on the bottom of the totem pole. But I thank God, being on the bottom, the God of the Bible did not forget about me. And my friends, he didn't forget about you. Aren't you glad that Jesus Christ reached down, grabbed you by your hand and pulled you up and saved you from your sins, put his arms around you and loved you and then filled you with his Holy Spirit. Tonight, I have one of the most unusual messages that perhaps I've ever preached that I will be teaching tonight. And I want you to tune in. First of all, I'm inviting everyone within the vicinity to come. Come and be in the live service. This is the first night of our We Are His Male Servants Conference. I want you to come. And there's nothing like being here. We hear from people all the time. We've had people to fly in from Miami. We have people to come in from great distances. And they said, wow, we loved watching it, but there's nothing like being here. It's something about the atmosphere of the house of God. You know, we never considered ourselves non-essential. We didn't go along with that. So I thank God have just multiplied the anointing, and I'm excited about it. But tonight I'm going to be delivering a word that God gave me that is near and dear to my heart. And I think that it's going to bless you, every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl. Come out tonight and be blessed of the Lord. Tomorrow night, my counterpart in the men's ministry. I'm so honored and I'm so appreciative to the presiding bishop of the Church of God in Christ, Bishop J. Drew Shears, for allowing me to work with this man of God. He is, the director of the men's ministry of the Church of God in Christ, Bishop Designee, soon to be Auxiliary Bishop Michael B. Golden Sr. And I'm excited about this man of God. He's actually Michael B. Golden Jr. So Pop, forgive me for that. But this man of God is going to be preaching here. The director of the men's perfecting men's ministry of the Church of God in Christ worldwide will be here Friday night ministering the word of the Lord. And also the director, a regional director on the national level, but he is the director of the men's ministry in Greater North Carolina. The pastor, Jimmy H. Benchon Sr., is also going to be the early speaker here on Friday night. And we're expecting men from all around to come and be a part of the service. And I want you to come. Saturday, we're having an awesome football camp. Amen. I'm excited about that, inviting the young men to come out. And we have some powerful people who are coming to help and share. And then yours truly will close on Sunday morning. And we'll talk a little bit about that more later. But I want to thank God for Elder Anthony Wilson. He's the president of our local men's ministry here at the Upper Room. And he's also a leader, one of the directors, one of the regional leaders of our missions to men's on the national level. He's doing a tremendous job, and I enjoy working with him, and it's going to be a tremendous meeting. Congratulations, Elder Wilson, on a job well done. I'm saying that, and we start tonight, but I can see it, and I'm excited about it. So I want you to join me tonight, even though the conference is going on. We're going to study the word of the Lord. I have something to say that God has given me that you want to hear and be a part of. So join me tonight right here at the Upper Room, Church of God in Christ, for Bible study. That's right, Bible study. I wasn't going to forget the drum roll, because all this that I'm talking about, the huge buildup, is what are we going to do? We're going to study the Bible together. I am under the impression that what people need more than anything else is the Word of God. the Word of God. And tonight, we're going to walk through the scriptures, and people, men, women, and children, are going to leave relieved, revived. That tension, that weight, that tightness, that unforgiveness, that stress, God's going to lift it all. I believe it with all of my heart. We'll see you tonight. And again, happy Jesus Pride Month to all of you. We're just celebrating Jesus because that's what saints do. God bless.